hanging up our Christmas tree. How funny was it that we had gifts under a naked tree? So what I started with is I've already gotten lit. I started from the bottom after I plugged it up and worked it up since the plug connects in the middle of it. That way I get this nice balanced pattern. I hate when I set the tree and the pattern of lights aren't right. It doesn't work out right when you go to add the ornaments and everything. So you definitely want to add the lights first. Afterwards, when I start with all of these beautiful ornaments, I go with the shape that's the same first, and I put all of the same shape on the tree to kind of get a pattern started. So if you see here, I'm starting with this particular shape, and I started here, and then I started a little ways down the side to put it here and here and here, just an even pattern, and I work that same pattern around the back so that it pops. I really like the pattern of all the different shapes and everything, but you don't want to have too many of silver in one spot or too many of gold in one spot. So I like doing the shapes first. And I love mixing silver and gold. I think I talked about that before in one of my videos. So I'm going to get a couple here to show you what I did with my pattern. And since I started off with the gold pattern, then I'll do the silver ones. And I also got these hooks. So you want to get the green hook because the silver hook, it stands out too much unless you do a white tree. So with the green trees, you want to do the green hooks and then you just slide it right through there. Just that simple. And I love it because I get stuck by the pine cones if I try to just slip this on the tree needle or something like that. I've done that before. So I like these better. And so since I have that pattern going, I'll go ahead and do the same pattern. Let me see if I can even reach up here. There we go. I think that's good. Yeah, so that balances out. And what I do is I follow the same pattern. Like so. And if it's too long for you when you go to hook it on there, you can always bend it any type of way. There's no hard science to it. So that one is a little bit off, but the tree branch is off, so I'm okay with that. I might come back and fix it two more times after everything is done. A little bit of OCD there. So, you see how easy it is to trim your tree? I'm sure you've done a tree before, but there's always like an easier science. And it's always great when you can have more involved. This year, my whole family left me to do this on my own, which is fine too. But at the same time, it is fun having my children and my husband help me decorate the setup. They did actually select the location of the tree this year. We typically have the tree in the corner, but this year we decided to put it in the center on this side of the room. The other side has the sofa and the desk. Sometimes I would also just take the ball and sit it in between the branch and leave it like that to make it a little bit quicker. Now, I don't suggest you doing that, but if you need to save a little bit of time, does work. And then you could go back and tweak the ones that look like they might fall off a little bit easier. And let's just hope no one runs into the tree or anything crazy and knocks all of them out. So that is a wrong shape. And hook that on there. I think that's safe to do. You might want to read the fine print that comes in the box with the lighting, because sometimes I don't. I'm a visual person. I look at it like, okay, hey, this is how it works, and it usually works that way. So. But you definitely want to be safe for the holidays. Okay, so I got those three sparkles going down the side. So I want to do the same thing here. It just pops when you have a pattern. When you go and put all the ornaments on there and you pile them on, it just gets to be too chaotic. For me anyway, I can't stand when I go. I try not to worry about it, but sometimes when I go to places and I see a tree unorganized or a picture frame crooked, I have to go and fix it with no one. Continue around here that way, and then after I get done with my ornaments, I add this really beautiful ribbon. What I love about holiday ribbon is it has wires on the end, so if you wanted to fold it and make a pattern, you could do that. After